Sree Rama, King Dasharatha of Ikshvagu dynasty, had four sons, Sree Rama through Kausalya, Lakshmana and Shatrughna through Sumitra, and Bharata through the youngest wife Kaikeyi. At the bidding of their father, Sree Rama and Lakshmana went with sage Vishwamitra to protect his sacrifice. On the way, they killed the demon Tatiki and drove away her brother Maricha. Sage Vishwamitra then took them to the palace of King Janaka. Sree Rama saw the sacred bow of Lord Shiva that was kept under worship in that palace. With due permission, he tried to bend and string the bow and it broke into two pieces. So King Janaka gave his daughter Sita in marriage to Sree Rama. His brothers were also married to the other daughters of Janaka. While returning back to Ayodhya, Sree Rama vanquished Parasurama and directed him to renounce his Rajoguna, to cultivate Sattvic temperament and to be an ascetic thenceforth. Dasharatha, having become very old, wanted to coronate Sree Rama to the throne. His youngest wife Kaikeyi interfered and Sree Rama was sent to the forest for 14 years. Lakshmana and Sita also followed Sree Rama. Dasharatha died unable to bear the separation of his son Sree Rama. Bharata ruled over Ayodhya as an agent of Sree Rama while he was in exile. In the forest, Sree Rama killed many Rakshasas and made the lives of many sages happy. He was living with his wife and Lakshmana for some time on the banks of the river Pampa. Shurpanaka, sister of Ravana, the demon king of Lanka, came there and saw the attractive figure of Sree Rama and wanted to marry him. Sree Rama and Lakshmana put her to shame. She ran to her brothers nearby, Kara and Dushana, and reported her fate. The two demons came with a large army and attacked the brothers. Sree Rama killed the whole lot of them, 14,000 strong, single-handed in less than 3 hours. Shurpanaka ran to Ravana and reported her fate and that of their brothers. She instigated Ravana to get Sita to be his wife. Ravana felt elated and with his friend Maricha, he went to the forest near Pampa. In the forest, Maricha transformed himself as a spotted golden deer. Sita saw the deer and wanted it. Sree Rama went after it to kill. Meanwhile, Ravana took away Sita by force and reached Lanka by the aerial route. Sree Rama killed Maricha and returned to the Kutir. But Sita was not be seen anywhere. He heard about the fate of Sita through Jatayu, a bird friend of Dasharatha, who was lying wounded, having been injured by Ravana while fighting. Sree Rama and Lakshmana went to Kishkindha and made friendship with the monkey king Sugriva and killed his enemy Vali. Sugriva deputed Hanuman and others in the search for Sita. Hanuman leaped over the sea and reached Lanka. He saw Sita in great distress in a garden. He set fire to the capital Lanka and returned to report his success to Sree Rama. Sree Rama started with a large army of monkeys, crossed the sea by a newly constructed bridge and reached Lanka. Vibhishana, brother of Ravana, came and sought protection of Sree Rama. The war began. Kumbhakarna, brother of Ravana, who sleeps for 6 months and eats and drinks for the other 6 months, was first killed by Sree Rama. Indrajit, the cunning son of Ravana, was killed by Lakshmana. A celestial car full of weapons came down from heaven for Sree Rama. Utilizing them, Sree Rama killed Ravana, the demon king of Lanka, having 10 heads. Vibhishana was crowned king of Lanka. Sree Rama subjected Sita to a fire test and she came out untarnished. Having proclaimed her chastity by this method to the world, Sree Rama with Sita, Lakshmana, Vibhishana and a host of friends boarded the aerial plane called Pushpaka, a vehicle of Kubera, forcibly taken and kept by Ravana. The plane reached Ayodhya. By that time, the 14 years of exile was completed. Sree Rama was received with great affection by Bharata, his three mothers, ministers, sages and hosts of common folk. Sree Rama was crowned as king of Ayodhya amidst the acclamations of the whole country. Ravana and Kumbhakarna were the gatekeepers of Vaikuntha, Jaya and Vijaya, and they were destroyed by the Supreme in the form of Sree Rama. This being their second rebirth, Vibhishana, Ravana and Kumbhakarna were all Brahmins, great grandsons of Pulastya Brahma, and were well learned in Vedas. Vibhishana was of Sattvic temperament, so he sought the protection of the Lord. Ravana was Rajasic. His 10 heads were the 10 Indriyas to which he was a slave, and he gave trouble to everybody. Kumbhakarna was of Tamasic temperament and never cared for the outside world. These three gunas are ever present in every man and they have to be integrated by discipline and spiritual knowledge to obtain and live in Ram Rajya, Atma Ram Rajya.